morning, everyone, and welcome to this week's edition of the Emberescent Vlog. So nice to see you all on this gloomy, chilly, hopefully snowy day when I'm recording this. We don't have any snow yet, but I'm hoping. But yeah, man, fall ended fast, and now it's winter, you know, because that's how New Mexico does things, right? So, but let's go ahead and get started. So, first of all, our big announcement, and unfortunately it's a bit of a sad one. Due to the rise in COVID cases, for the moment, we are ceasing any in-person meetings. I think it's just best that we be safe with some of the orders that are in place and things like that. We're just not going to be doing in-person right now. So high schoolers, still join us on Monday nights for our Zoom hangouts. And we'll still be doing these vlogs too for everybody else. So stay with us through that. And I know this is a tough time. So my love is going out to all you guys, and I hope you guys are all hanging in there. The next announcement is that tomorrow at 6 o'clock, all of you guys that are in Flame, the youth leadership team, we have a big, very important meeting tomorrow having to do with all these changes, talking about maybe doing a Zoom retreat in the future, which I think would be very cool. So please join us for that meeting if you're available. Please let me know if you can't. I'll be sending out a reminder about it again today. And even if you're not in Flame and you'd like to be involved in helping us make some decisions for the year, please let me know and I'll give you the code to jump on. Now, of course, no announcement will be complete without the dad joke of the week. Well, guys, you know, people say they pick their nose, but I feel like I was born with mine. Ah, guys, they are rough. Well, without any further ado, let's jump into our theme today, which is a bit of a different one. So we're kind of changing up a little bit. So a couple of weeks ago, if any of you guys attended Mass, you saw that it was the feast day of St. John the 23rd. So I know it was a couple of weeks ago now, but I thought that today we could do a little bit of a different theme for us. You know, normally we're talking about some big thoughts of our faith. We're talking about something having to do with the gospel, things like that. But I thought that today we could talk a little bit about St. John the 23rd. He is our namesake, after all. And I think that we oftentimes don't give enough thought to that. I think maybe a lot of us don't know much about St. John the 23rd. I remember I went to John the 23rd when I was a kid, before it was St. John the 23rd, before he was a saint. And I don't remember knowing too much about him. And I think it's especially important to learn about St. John the 23rd, because in many ways, John the 23rd did more to change and alter our faith than all but a few popes before him. He really transformed our faith into what we know it as today and what we love about it today. In fact, the way we go to Mass today can mostly be attributed to St. John the 23rd and the things that he wanted to bring into the church. But before we get there, we need to look at how St. John the 23rd got to even be Pope. We got to kind of go back a little bit and look at his life. Let's start at the beginning, as most stories do. So before John the 23rd became Pope, he was known as Angelo Giuseppe Roncalli. That was his birth name. And he led a life that many would describe as pretty unremarkable. As a priest, as a bishop, and later a cardinal, Angelo was not known for rocking the boat. He was not known as one of these figures in our faith who wanted to radically change things or wanted to bring a lot of change into the church. So when the previous pope, Pius XII, died in 1958, Angelo was named pope in a surprise vote. He wasn't really expecting it. Not too many other people were, but he was seen as a safe choice, a transitional pope, because he was already pretty old, who would serve for a time until another, maybe more fit pope could be chosen. He was kind of the safe choice. Now here's where things get interesting. Those that elected him could not have been more wrong, and in the best way. Because when Angelo became pope, he took the name of John the 23rd, and he wasted no time in rocking the boat. One of the big priorities that St. John the 23rd had when he became pope was he called for an ecumenical council. Now, this is a big deal because there hadn't been another ecumenical council in over 100 years. So he's calling this meeting of leaders from across the church that hadn't happened in over 100 years. So that was a big deal in and of itself. But then what he ordered the council to do, and this council would later be known as the Second Vatican Council. What he asked them to do was very radical. He said that he wanted the council to, and I quote, open the windows of the church and let in some fresh air. So what exactly does that mean, opening these windows and letting this fresh air in? So what does this mean, opening the windows and letting fresh air in? Well, for Pope John XXIII, what it meant was modernizing the church a bit. And he did this in several ways. First of all, do you like going to Mass and being able to understand the language that is being spoken? Do you like being able to understand the whole Mass? If you do, you got St. John XXIII to thank for that. Because before him, the Mass was in Latin. And then the homily would be given in the local language. But the whole rest of the Mass was all done in the Latin language. The idea behind it, and it was a good one, was that every church across the world would be having the Mass happening in the same language. But Pope John XXIII realized a problem with that. The people couldn't understand. And this was a big focus of St. John XXIII's in the Second Vatican Council, was making the Mass, I mean, it was more oriented towards us, the lay people, the followers. Now, that wasn't the only way it changed. Do you like that the priest faces you during the Mass? Again, you got Vatican II and St. John XXIII to thank for that. Before the Mass was changed from Vatican II, the priest would face the back of the church, would face the crucifix. Again, a beautiful image. He was facing Jesus. But again, it doesn't bring the Mass, our faith, to us very much. So again, it's orienting things toward us. And another big thing that changed was making us, the lay people, have a role in the parish. Now, I know that a lot of you guys have heard that we have a parish council at the church. That didn't really exist before Vatican II. Things like that didn't really exist. Our flame team, that wouldn't have really existed before Vatican II. So Vatican II said is people from the parish, people who are the followers, should have a voice in what the church is doing, what the mission is. Really, Vatican II asked us to step up and ask the church to recognize us more. So in these ways and more, Vatican II and St. John XXIII really did open up the church. It opened up those windows and let that fresh air and let it modernize a bit. Let us feel like we had an important role in what the church was doing. Now, here's the incredible part. Pope John XXIII, he did all of this in less than 5 years. St. John XXIII passed away in 1963, before all the efforts of Vatican II could even be completed. Now, this was a big, tumultuous time for Vatican II. People wondered, man, are they just going to scrap it? Is the next pope just going to say, nope, this is too much, we're just going to get rid of it? But no, the next pope actually made sure that it happened. He held up Pope John XXIII's mission. So now that we know this story, what can we take away from St. John XXIII? What can we look at as our namesake and feel proud about? Well, one, we have him to thank for our church looking exactly how it does today, which I think is incredibly inspirational. St. John XXIII is an incredibly inspirational saint, which is pretty incredible for a little squat, chubby man. Everyone kind of laughed at how he looked, and you guys seen the statue at our church. That's not that far away from how St. John XXIII looked. He was kind of this short, portly man, and look at the great things he did. I look at that as crazy inspirational. I think another thing is that he was really a model for our church. I think St. John XXIII realized something that the church had maybe been missing before. That was that we needed to be put more front and center. We need to be involved in our church. See, being a follower doesn't mean just following in Christ's footsteps. It also means realizing his mission in our world in deep ways, being involved in our church. And that's what Vatican II really allowed us to do. I think what Vatican II also allowed us to do in St. John XXIII is that it let us realize that we are central to our faith, and also that we need to take it seriously. We need to step up and be a leader in our church and take that role as seriously as it can be. And finally, I think that Vatican II and St. John XXIII helped us realize the gifts of the Mass and beyond. That they are really for us as followers, and that we need to feel them intimately. We need to be a part of them. That's a really beautiful thing that St. John the 23rd gave us. So now that you know the story, whenever you go to the church, which I know is a little difficult right now, but whenever you think about our name, or you wear your St. John the 23rd shirt, one of your youth shirts, think about that. Think about the symbolism of St. John 23rd and what he did for our church. And think about and be proud about it, how special it is that he is our namesake. Here's a crazy thing, guys. Father Ark, when he started the church, he picked the name John the 23rd before he was even a saint, which is not common. But he knew how important of a figure he would continue to be in our faith. And he just became a saint just a few years ago. In fact, he was canonized by Pope Francis in 2014, I believe. So he's just that recent of a saint. So let us realize how special he is to our faith, especially as parishioners of St. John the 23rd Catholic community. Well, guys, I think that's a good spot to end. I hope you guys got something from this today, some inspiration from St. John the 23rd. And I wanted to close with a prayer. So this is a prayer from St. John the 23rd, and it's a prayer for strength. So let's get into a prayerful space of mind. I'll lose my hat here. In the name of the Father, of the Son, of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Every day I need you, Lord, but today especially. I need some extra strength to face whatever is to come. This day, more than any other day, I need to feel you near me to strengthen my courage and to overcome my fear. By myself, I cannot meet the challenge of the hour. We are frail human creatures. We need a higher power to sustain us in all that life may bring. And so, dear Lord, hold my trembling hand. Be with me, Lord, this day, and stretch out your powerful arm to help me. May your love be upon me as I place my hope in you. Amen. In the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. Thank you so much, guys. It was so nice to be with you today, and I hope that you took some inspiration from St. John 23rd today and something to carry in to the rest of your week. I love you all very much. Hopefully, I can see you again in person soon. Until then, we'll keep doing this. Join us for our online hangouts, and have a great rest of your week. Bye, guys.